Hey guys, I'm gonna make a quick little tour overview of this 2015 Dodge Charger SRT or RT. Sorry, I apologize. The tour is at night, but I'm not really in this area all the time, so I'm gonna get started. I'm only doing it because the lighting here is really, really good. But coming to the front, you have these really big wheels. I don't know if they're 20-inch or 22s, but they're really, really nice. I know they're upgrades, so really nice. So you have the 5.7-liter Hemi V8, obviously. Just have a single moonroof. Come in a sticker, I don't know if you can pick up because the light's on, but come around, 40 grand. Here's all your options if you want to pause it. Sorry about this tour, it's kind of not going to be very professional, I guess. Professional. You have the really nice rear end with the big bar tail lights, spoiler, and your really nice stainless steel exhaust tips. It's really attractive looking. You have halogen headlights and fog lights. I just want to make this quick, or projector, I'm sorry. And then here's your intelligent access. Coming in, you have a full power driver seat with your lumbar over here, seat controls here, leather over here, and then Alcantara suede, which is pretty nice. Really thickly bolstered seats. Coming on in, now the seats really just hug you in as soon as you get in, but you have a really thick leather wrap steering wheel. It's not bolstered, it's just thick. Paddle shifters here, automatic headlights and fog lights. You can turn them on. Then you have really attractive gauges, which these are really nice for me. Coming to the dash, it is all soft touch. And my Uconnect, I think it's called, but I have a little battery, so I want to get this done. Push button start, dual zone climate control, heated and cooled cup holders. I believe it's a 5 or 6 speed automatic with your slap shift. Leather stitched grabber thingy. I totally forgot what it's called. Your charger over there, stitched door panels, sunroof, black headliner. Here's all your controls up here. And you do have the Alpine sound system with soft touch up here, more leather stitching here, all your power controls here and such. I really give Dodge credit. They really did a nice job on this, or their whole lineup actually. But Footline glove box, leather stitch right here. Then it is damped with more felt lining. I again apologize for this tour. It's all over the place and it's kind of slow, but sorry, whatever. Then I'll see if we can turn this on. I don't think you can, but nope. So we'll just go into the back. Make sure it's unlocked. Chrome door handle. Just a really nice classic styling. While coming to the back, as you can see, there's a hump back there, and the light is still on. So, coming to the back, you just sink into these seats, and you feel kind of claustrophobic back here. This is just a really big seat. Like, that's my hand right there, and then some. But it's just because they're really thickly bolstered. Dual mat pockets, air vents right here, then 2-stage heated seats with your 12-volt power outlet. Then that big hump because it's rear-wheel drive, obviously. Right here is your cup holders with storage. And then you have a little pass-through, which is covered up by this little padding right here. Headrests are non-adjustable. That's all right. I believe this is, though. Yeah, it is. Then headroom is pretty good, but the window, your head is, like, right here, so sun will blast in on it if it's hot out. But, here's everything else. And I'm kind of, like, in a hick town, too. Materials do carry through. Everything is really nice. I would totally buy one of these. So if I had to buy an automaker, I'd go probably Ford, Honda, Dodge, and then whatever else is out there. Chevy kind of lost my pride or hope, whatever, with all these recalls and stuff. And they are projector beam headlights with HID, then just regular halogen fog lights. Everything is really nice blacked out, so. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching this quick little tour. Talk to you later.